blundering Glasgow nurse has been sanctioned after a catalogue of errors at a critical care unit put patients at unwarranted risk of harm. Imelda Azubuike, a registered nurse at the Glasgow Royal Infirmary, was brought before a fitness to practice committee at the Nursing and Midwifery Council, NMC, in Edinburgh last week on 9 charges relating to a lack of competence. Azubuike, who took up the role at the critical care unit in October 2013, admitted all charges between November 2016 and March 2017, which included giving one patient 10 times the amount of medication they were due. She has been handed a conditions of practice order sanction for 18 months. The committee noted how there had been concerns regarding her practice for a lengthy period, initially being subject to an informal supportive improvement plan before being put on a formal stage 1 capability procedure. Read more: pensioner waited 2 hours for treatment yards from Glasgow hospital entrance. The first 6 of the 9 charges came during the informal warning period. In December 2016, Azubuike woke a patient up from sedation despite previously been instructed not to. That same month, she admitted increasing the rate of a patient's to 10 mls, instead of the 1 mls as instructed. She was later found to have made a medication error for another patient. And a week later was deemed unable to safely dispense 4 medication. Her catalogue of dangerous errors continued in February 2017 when she printed the wrong blood sample for a patient. In March she also failed to notice or act on a chest drain that had become detached. Read more: Craig Tara holiday scam leaves families hundreds out of pocket. The NMC report read, "Nurses occupy a position of privilege and trust in society. Patients and their families must be able to trust nurses with their lives and the lives of their loved ones. To justify that trust, nurses must make sure that their conduct at all times justifies both their patients' and the public's trust in the profession." It added, "The panel considered that your lack of competence had put patients at unwarranted risk of harm in the past and was likely to in the future. The panel considered that, due to the clinical failings and the breaches of the code identified in this case, that you had also breached a fundamental tenet of the profession." Azubuike resigned from her role in May 2017 and has been unable to find a nursing job since then despite being desperate to work again. She has received a possible offer of employment in a care home, however the prospective employer was keen to hear the report's outcome. Conditions imposed include not being able to work in an intensive or critical care environment. She is also unable to work as an agency or bank nurse. Be in charge of AS. For more on this story, visit the news article link.